Él como quiera nos da gracia y misericordia y nos ama como quiera. Okay? Isaiah, did you want to share?
I want to start out by saying that I really do appreciate everyone being here, like Vanessa said, being all together. I know my dad would appreciate that and love that very much. And when I found out he passed, the first thing that came to my mind, of course, was he's gone. But the other thing that came to my mind is that I need to say a few things about my father at his funeral, because I would regret it so much if I didn't. And this is a eulogy to my father. His sunrise was July 28th of 1959. His sunset was September 30th, 2018, at 3:20 a.m. He was 59 years old, and he passed due to complications of blood cancer. José Antonio Rodriguez was an amazing son, brother, uncle, cousin, and most importantly, an amazing father. Most of you knew him as Tonio. I guess that was a family name. Others knew him as Rocío. And I knew him as Dad. He was born on July 29th of 1959, in Ciudad Victoria, Tamaulipas, Mexico. He was known as Tio because he was a family man to many, because he enjoyed being around everyone, and others enjoyed being around him. In my eyes, my father was a perfect person to me, because he was always there for people. A person who accepted people who had the good and bad in them. A person who never showed his emotions to the public, but deep down, he loved everyone and everything. My father gave a tough love relationship to people. When I used to tell him I love him, he would reply with a gracias, mijo. I didn't have to hear the words I love you too, because I knew my father had the same love for me as I had for him. A father and son relationship, I would call that, when it came to him showing his tough love. The word father is a noun, and it stands for a man in relation to his child or children. So I guess you can say everyone was his children, because he loves everyone. My dad was the most amazing father figure I could ever ask for. He gave me his all when he had nothing to give. He provided me with clothes on my back, a house to sleep in when I would go with him, and a hot meal, even when the only hot meal was fast food. We both would eat as if we were living our best lives. Growing up, I wanted nothing but my dad. I would want nothing from the world but to be with him. When I was little, I would always cry because I would hate to see him leave the house. That's how much I wanted to be with him. Even to be as clingy as possible to make him annoyed, I would want to be with him. Till this day, I wish him nothing but to hear his voice again. Till this day, I wish nothing but to have his full embrace. And till this day, I wish him nothing but to absolutely just be with him. I love my father for many reasons. When he would pick me up from school, I would have so much to tell him about my week. I don't know if he really listened or not, but it was just nice to tell him everything. To tell him things I would be scared to tell my friends and family. This showed me my father didn't judge me and me being me. From telling him my wildest dreams about my future, to telling him about my day, to asking him what looks better when it came to an outfit or haircut, to telling him what I'm looking to eat, even though he didn't mind because he ate everything. To tell him about me being me. When I fully came out to my dad, I cried, of course. I cried because I had thought, with my decisions and my sexual preference, that he would be angry or even upset with the thought that his son, his only son, was gay. And I'm not surprised. But when I had the courage to tell him, he didn't judge me. This is one of those situations where I told my dad everything. When I came out to him, instead of judging me, he told me, well, that's it. You're still my son. I don't think anything has changed, has it? And when that happened, I learned that my father was a supportive father. My dad loved and supported me so much that he wanted me, but my mother didn't. He would come in as her role, just to play both parts, to support me. But my dad was like this to everyone. He loved everyone and supported everyone with their decisions and choices. His way of supporting and loving a person was probably with a joke, though. My dad was known for his cheesy jokes. He had those dad jokes where you either laughed because it was really funny, or you laughed because it really wasn't funny, you just wanted him to feel good. That was his way of being a deal. That was his way of being a family man. When it came to being a family man, it came to him being there for everyone, especially his mother, my grandmother, Gloria Rodriguez. But if you're a part of the family, she's a mom. Pretty much every day he spent his time with her, eating breakfast, lunch, dinner, and of course they would spend their time watching shows. He cared for her so much. And I don't know if it was her cooking, because if you had a mas food, then you know what I'm talking about. Or the fact that he just wanted to be with his mom. And he really did love her. He told me every day. He had this type of love for everyone. The chance he got to spend time with you, he would take it and cherish it. Whether it was talking to you, eating with you, or even just visiting Ama, because he was always there. He cherished his family and loved every person. And I want that to be one of the things my father was remembered for. I want him to be remembered for the love he had for his family, for the cheesy jokes, the support he showed, his laugh, his smile, and just everything you can remember from him being the man he was, the family man he was. Whether you knew him as Don or El Tio, or from my point of view, my dad, I want you to remember him of his big heart, the heart he had for everyone. When I had said earlier, he gave me his all, he had nothing to give. That's his way of loving his family. That was his way of loving his friends. Because he gave a piece of his heart to all he knew. And that's what family man does. That's what my father did. Right now, I am currently broken because of the loss of my father. When I used to tell him about my wildest dreams, about my future, he would support that. I remember a conversation I had with him was, when I'm older, Dad, I'm not staying in the ghetto. I'm staying in downtown in a condo. And he said, oh, really? Well, me too, then. I'm going with you. I said, yeah, you're coming with me, Dad. And he said, but for me, I need an elevator up because you know I'm not going to be able to walk. I said, yeah, Dad, we can have an elevator. What I think is heartbreaking to me is that my dad will not see me, physically see me, succeed in all that I wanted to succeed. From now, he won't physically see me walk that stage. He won't see me graduate from college. He won't see me do the careers that I choose. I want to be a teacher. He won't be able to see me do so many things that I don't know what I will accomplish yet, but I know I will do it for him. Because my father was my world. I loved my father. Whether he was your brother, your uncle, your friend, cousin, and in my case, I was his son. Just know that he loves each and every one of you. But to my father, who lies in heaven watching over me, this isn't a goodbye, Dad. This is just an I'll see you later. Because I know you know I hated saying bye when you dropped me off. The last thing I said to my father was that I'll see you later. The last thing I remember was seeing him suffer. And I know now that he's not suffering. I know now that he's here with me and all of you. And I know now that he's here in a better place that's not suffering. So, Dad, remember when I told you that I'll see you later? I mean that. So I'm so mean again, Dad. I love you. And I want to say thank you for all you've done for me and for the people you love. Just for everything. From the lessons you taught me, to the memories we shared, to the good and the bad, through the support you gave me when I was struggling to find myself. I thank you for that. Through being a father to me. Because I didn't take you for granted, because not many people have the chance to have a dad. I did. And I want to say thank you. I want to say thank you for everything. For taking me in when Anna didn't want to do her job. For giving me an allowance of $20 every week for school. For just taking me in and being your son when you could have walked out and you didn't have to be there for me. So, Dad, these aren't my final goodbyes or my last words. This is just till I see you later.
Thank you for sharing. It seems like you had a wonderful relationship with your father. Open your Bibles to Psalm.